Good morning, everybody. This is Mary Catherine at Red Robin Farm. And I am painting this morning, as I just said on my blog. And yesterday I spent some time making a new, I think, playlist on YouTube and putting all the watercolor videos there that I like. I found this one fella. His name is Grant. Maybe I'll try to do links to these. He did this kind of sloppy daisy. Is that sunflowers? I don't know what they are. You know, this was very fun to do. This was not great. As you can see in the middle, that some of that got too dark, kind of too sloppy. But it was a decent first attempt. And I enjoyed it so much. Then I did a second one, and I was a little more careful in applying that brown and violet in the middle and tried to do my shading a little better. I like the speckles. There's a little light blue background. I'll probably do some more of these if they sell. You just never know what's going to sell. Then I found a girl who, and she's evidently good because she said she couldn't show us one of hers that she did last year of an iris because it was in a gallery. And I was like, oh, ooh la la. But I did this while watching her video. And it's pretty good. It's not as good as hers, obviously. But it was fun. I guess that's the big thing, is it fun? And I could probably do more of those and do them better. And then I thought, she had an iris there, because irises are blooming right now. And she said to paint from real life if you can. And I'm not going to go outside and cut any irises, but I had a photograph of one from my yard. And so I pulled it up, and maybe I'll link it here on the blog too. Anyway, so it was a yellow, gorgeous yellow iris, and this is not, you know, a perfect representation. Really, somebody said that, someone of these famous watercolors said that watercolor is only supposed to give an impression of what the thing is. It's not supposed to be a true-to-life kind of thing. That was helpful to me. There's a lot of ways to give an impression. Oops, anyway. So here's the yellow iris. I kind of like that. It's still drying. I did some salt on there, hoping when I take it off, I don't know if you can see the salt, that it'll give a kind of a veiny look that I'm looking for. Anyway, the last two times I've gone to the farmer's market, I've sold 8 cards each of those 2 weeks. I always sell some. 8 is quite a few. That's $40. And this last time, a very sweet young girl walked up to my table at the end and bought all 5 of my, I call these ball flowers just because they're so round. And she bought all the ones I had, and some of them were rather old. One of them was the first one I ever painted. So this morning, I'm going to do about 4 of these in different colors to replace those. So it's just so encouraging to still be selling these because it means I still get to paint. I can't paint these indefinitely and have them sitting around the house. All my chicken cards always sell. See, I've got my, write my blog post, playing my Pandora, drinking my tea. This is the peppermint tarragon. Yes, peppermint tarragon lemon balm that I dried last year. I'm still drinking it with some honey and lemon. It's delicious. So anyway, that's what I'm painting this morning. I'm also going to wrap up some soap and shampoo bars that you see over there. I need to do that. Vacuum the house. That was something. So, kind of taking it easy and enjoying my work this morning. Thanks for stopping by. Talk to you later.